Very good morning to all the students of class plus 1B. Yes, beta, we are doing chapter Silk Road by Nick Middleton. Those who were not there, please, you are having the chance to understand it once again. But tomorrow onwards, I won't be giving the summary once again. So please have a look on the, you can say, points. So this chapter named Silk Road, because actually that was known as earlier Silk Route, because of the commercial trade between China and India. And the silk was the product which was being exported. And due to the old commercial route, the name of the chapter has kept as they have kept as Silk Road. Fine. So Nick Middleton, narrator, he himself will be experiencing the route. He himself will be, you know, treading through the path of Silk Road. That's why the name of the chapter is Silk Road. So he is going to actually do the Kora. I told you already, religious journey. You know that you might have seen people go to Amarnath, people go to Mani Mahesh and such places. This is Kora, religious journey, pilgrimage. Fine. And Nick Middleton is also going to do so. So his journey from slopes of Rabu to Mount Kailash, how he reaches over there, how he will be exploring the Himalayan beauty, that is to be seen here. Okay, so completion of Kora, whether he will be, he took up this journey just to complete his this journey or of pilgrimage, specifically religious bent of mind. So Lamo gave him sheepskin coat, I told you, when he was about to leave Rabu, that place. He's, stayed there for a while, and Lamo was the girl, local girl over there. And she became friendly with narrator Nick Middleton. And she thought that he did not have proper, you know, warm clothes, which are required for the further journey. So that's why she gave him a sheepskin long sleeves coat. And he kept it as a gesture of, you can say, she gifted him. Then he hired, this is all about narrator only, fine. So narrator hired Satan, Zakar, for his journey. So Satan is, who is Satan? He is silent, okay. Satan is a local Tibetan, clear? So first and foremost character is Nick Middleton, narrator himself. We're going to talk about his journey through the Silk Road. And how he hires the local Tibetan named Satan, and he hires his car, you can say, for the further journey. Then we have Lamo, I told you, she gifted that sheepskin coat. And then Daniel. Daniel is the translator. He understands Tibetan language. Narrator does not. So that's why he has hired a translator, so that he can have ease in the journey. And then we have last character is Norbu, whom he will be meeting while after reaching Darchan. So he's going to Darchan now. Fine. So various passes are there, various places are there. So Norbu ka abhi hum naam nahi lete hain because he will be coming at the last. But these characters, this character came. So this character has also entered in Daniel. So you should know Satan, Daniel here. So now he hired Satan's car for his journey. And he also took along Daniel because he is the translator to escort him to Darchan. So that Darchan pochte raaste mein, he has to go to n number of places. He has to talk to people. So that's why he has hired Daniel, so that he did not have any language problem. Okay, we discussed the problems, various problems yesterday only, that what sort of problems we can have during the journey. So he met Norbu at Darchan. Darchan's only cafe, you know, Darchan was a place where no pilgrimage were seen, and very less number of people, and no, these places are not, you know, because of less vegetation, less, you can say, number of population. So there are no more, you can say, shops or restaurants and hotels. So only one cafe was there at Darchan. He will be meeting Norbu over there. So narrator and Norbu, they will become friends at the last. How they further their journey. It's not the end of the journey. They have to start their pilgrimage from Darchan. So to reach that Darchan, he has to go to many places. So he started his journey from Rabu. Then he has to reach to Mount Kailash. But in between, firstly, he went to Darchan and he hired Satan's car and he hired Daniel, the translator. Is that clear to you all? Any doubt, beta? You can ask me, you can write in the chat box that, ma'am, you just repeat this thing or whatever you want. I will repeat, because if you carry your doubts further, you won't be able to understand the whole story then. The journey is about to begin. I'm going to share the screen. Any doubt, beta? No doubts? All clear? So now some students, more students have joined, beta. Those who are going to have their vaccine tomorrow, please wear proper school uniform also. And after that, you can say you can wrap your sleeves up of the shirt, because you're going to get so dress up accordingly so that it is easy for you to wrap up the shirt and you can get your vaccine on your arm. Before that, you can say you need to hydrate yourself, drink milk, and please have your proper meal. Khana kha ke aana hai aapko. Don't think that ki, empty stomach, on empty stomach you're not supposed to come. Fine, you should eat something before getting the shot. And please bring your Aadhaar card. So I will be putting up the message once again, but I'm just talking to you. That's why I'm saying maximum students have joined now. And bring your mobile phone, or one of the parents might be there for you, because nothing is going to happen. Don't get scared. Those who have received their first shot recently, and that the time for the, if the time for the second shot is there, they can come. If there is no, you can say, because dates, I just was checking that 9 students have already received their first shots, but recently, so you need not come. Okay, few days back only they have received the first shot, so they are not eligible for that. So it needs a span of 84 days in between. So accordingly, you have to see. Okay. And the ones who are going to have their first shot, please follow the norms. Okay. Chaliye. So we were reading about maneuvers on some predetermined course, plumes of dust billowed into the crisp, clean air. So the journey has started. He's going there. And now he will be, what sort of scenes he will be eyewitnessing, that is to be seen. As hills started to push up once more from the rocky wilderness, we passed solitary Drokbars. So I told you who are the Drokbars, those who are the local people. They keep the herd of the animals. They are taking them to the, for eating out and for that stalls, and sometimes sheep and sometimes mastiffs, dogs also, fine. So we will be reading about that. Drokbars tending their flocks. Sometimes men, sometimes women. So it is not like that ki only women or men can be there. It can be anyone. These well-wrapped figures would pause and stare at our car. So when narrator Nick Middleton was moving further with Daniel and Satan in his car, they are going to Darchan now. And in between, he saw that many Drokbars, many local people who are taking their flocks and group of animals together, they look at them, they wave at them, they have close look at them. You know, they are so excited that somebody has come to their state. So the sheep would take evasive action, veering away from the speeding vehicle. And even sheep and animals, they would behave. They were scared by seeing the jeep. We passed nomads, dark tents pitched in splendid isolation. You know, the local people, community nomads, different communities live over there in isolation. They have huge tents. Then they saw a huge black dog, a Tibetan Mastiff. So this is again one breed of the dog. Standing guard, these beasts would cock their great big heads when they become aware of our approach and fix us in their sights. So these mastiffs, these huge dogs can, you know, kill people even. As we continue to draw closer, they would explode into action, speeding directly towards us like a bullet from a gun and nearly as fast. So when narrator's car was moving fast, these huge dogs, mastiffs, they started, you know, coming towards the jeep as fast as they could run, as if the shot of the bullet from the gun. So they were so fast and running, very quick in action. These shaggy monsters, blacker than the darkest night. So what is the color of these dogs? Very dark in color, black. Usually wore bright red collars. So they barked furiously with massive jaws. This is a description of the horrible, you can say, dogs. They are very monstrous dogs, and they are having wearing red collars, bright colored collars. They bark furiously with huge jaws. They were completely fearless of our vehicle. See, they are so brave that they are not at all scared of the vehicle as well. Shooting straight into our path, causing Satan to brake and swerve. So even Satan, who was driving his car, he has to put the brakes by seeing this, because they were not at all afraid of the car, the speeding vehicle. The dog would make chase 100 meters or so before easing off. So these dogs are not at all easily, you can make them run away. They're so strong. So for 100 meters or so before easing off, having seen us off the property, so they kept on chasing them, and unless and until they became like unseen to them. It wasn't difficult to understand why ferocious Tibetan Mastiffs became popular in China's imperial courts as hunting dogs brought along the Silk Road in ancient times as tribute from Tibet. So this is one historical fact about Silk Road, that, you know, these Tibetan Mastiffs, these the dogs which are found in Tibet specifically, they became very popular in, you know, China's imperial courts. Why they became popular? Because of their appearance, because of their ferociousness, the way they were used as hunting dogs. So they brought along the Silk Road in ancient times as tribute from Tibet. So they are also important to the journey of Silk Road. By now we could see snow-capped mountains gathering on the horizon. We entered a valley where the river was wide and mostly clogged with ice, brilliant white and glinting in the sunshine. So they have entered the place, a valley. Now they could see a river and icy river. You can say ice is clogged over there. Shine, sunshine could be seen. The trail hugged its bank, twisting with the meanders. So this is the beautiful sight which they have reached. Gradually they gained height and valley sides closed in. So finally, so he's just describing better the natural beauty, how he eyewitnessed the beautiful sights and sounds of nature. The turns became sharper and the ride bumpier. So now their ride has become quite bumpier, up and down, and Satan now in third gear as we continue to climb. So climb is on third gear of the car. Track moved away from the icy river, laboring through steeper slopes that sported big rocks daubed with patches of bright orange lichen. So they are describing that how from slopes to the difficult, you can say, you know, the ones who are into driving the cars and going through these such kind of travels, they can relate that how it is difficult for the driver to ride also. So that's why he has hired local driver too, so that he can go, and they are, you know, acquainted with the paths also. Big rocks and big patches on the way, and how they were reaching there. I felt the pressure building up in my ears, held my nose, snorted and cleared them. Now, the more farther you go, the more upside you go, less oxygen, and it is definitely going to affect your health. We struggled round another tight bend and Satan stopped. Now he was having, you know, some problem in his nose, and he started snorting and clearing his throat, and he had opened his door and jumped out of his seat before I realized what was going on. Satan stopped the car and he jumped out of the seat. "Snow," said Daniel, as he too excited the vehicle, letting in a breath of cold air as he did so. He said, "You can see the snow outside. A swath of white stuff lay across the track in front of us, stretching for maybe 15 meters before it petered out and the dirt trail reappeared." They could see swath, you can say, big white stuff of that icy layers in front of them, and they were so excited to see. The snow continued on either side of us, dono sides pe snow. So they were amazed to see that scene, smoothing the abrupt bank on the upslope side. The bank was too steep for our vehicle to scale, so there was no way around the snow patch. When they jumped out, Daniel and Satan, and snow began to slither and slide forward, stamping his foot from time to time to ascertain how sturdy it was. So they were walking in the ice now, stamping their feet I joined Daniel and Satan. So narrator had to join them. He had no other option. I looked at my wristwatch. We were at 5,210 meters above sea level. Please mark it. That's why his nose started getting blocked and he was not having proper breathing and all. The snow didn't look too deep to me, but the danger was not its depth. The Daniel said, so much as it's icy top layer, if we slip off, the car could turn over. The danger was that if they slip, the car could turn over, he suggested, as we saw Satan grab handfuls of dirt and fling them across the frozen surface. We both pitched in, and when the snow was spread with soil, Daniel and I stayed out of the vehicle to lighten Satan's load. So it had become very difficult for all to drive because it was so ice everywhere. So they were, you know, helping Satan in that, taking the car further. He backed up and drove towards the dirty snow. So he was driving. That's why they have got off the car, ki car easily chal paye icy place pe, icy surface pe, and slowly drove its length without apparent difficulty. So then they helped Satan by getting off from the car. 10 minutes later, we stopped at another blockage. Not good, sir, Satan announced as he jumped out again to survey the scene. This time he decided to try and drive round the snow. Again, ek next chunk aaya ice ka. It's not that easy to reach such places. You might have heard many incidents of, you can say, people could not stop. You know, many accidents that do occur because driver could not control the car or brakes failed or because of the icy surface. You know, many scenes, many videos become viral. So when going to such places, a lot of precautions, a lot of experience and good luck also required. So though they have taken the risk, but it is so difficult. So Satan himself, being driver of the same place, a local driver, he himself is saying that it's not easy, sir. Slope was steep and studded with major rocks. Anyhow, Satan negotiated them, so he handled it. His four-wheel drive vehicle lurching from one obstacle to the next. In so doing, he cut off one of the hairpin bends, regaining the trail further up where the snow had not drifted. So anyhow, he was able to take his vehicle further where snow was not there. I checked my watch again as we continued to climb in the bright sunshine. We crept past 5,400 meters and my head began to throb horribly. Now, Nick Middleton, narrator, he's going to have health issues. I took gulps from my water bottle, which is supposed to help a rapid ascent. We finally reached the top of the pass at 5,501.5 meters. It was marked by a large cairn of rocks. You know, it's coming up lik chuke ho pehle. Pile of stones. So big pile of rocks festooned with white silk scarves and ragged prayer flags. We all took a turn round the cairn in a clockwise direction as is the tradition. And Satan checked the tires of his vehicle. They stopped at the petrol tank and partially unscrewed the top, which emitted a loud hiss. The lower atmospheric pressure was allowing the fuel to expand. It sounded dangerous to me. Maybe, sir, Satan laughed, but no smoking. My headache soon cleared as we carried down the other side of the pass. It was 2 o'clock by the time we stopped for lunch. So after having the headache and a lot of difficulties passing the icy surface, they finally reached to have their lunch at 2 o'clock. Then they ate hot noodles inside a long canvas tent. So it was erected beside a dry salt lake. Aisi cheeze milti hai wahan pe, you are not going to get a 5-star hotel over there. So he got a camp, work camp was erected, and in that canvas tent, they sat and they ate noodles. The plateau is pockmarked with salt flats and brackish lake. So that place where they were staying, that plateau was having lot of salt flats. Salt flats means houses whose roofs were covered with snow, and such sort of lakes and vestiges of the Tethys Ocean which bordered Tibet from the great continental collision that lifted it skyward. So collision, you can say border area of that Tibet. This one was a hive of activity, men with pickaxes and shovels. You know, they are having the shovels because to remove the ice, they need instruments. Men are carrying their instruments, trudging back and forth in their long sheepskin coats. So वहाँ पे लोग, that's why ना लामा gifted him sheepskin coat. Because in icy cold weather, you can wear that only. And salt encrusted boots means salt encrusted means gum boots which you wear during going to such places. All wore sunglasses against the glare as a steady stream of blue trucks emerged from the blindingly white lake laden with piles of salt. So that was the common scene. People were wearing shades and wearing gum boots and sheepskin coats because this is the dress required to survive at such a place. By late afternoon, we had reached the small town of Hoor. Please underline. Now they have reached another milestone. They have reached the small town of Hoor, Hor. Back on the main east-west highway that followed the old trade route from Lhasa to Kashmir. So that was the old trade route, जिसको Silk Road कहते थे. From Lhasa to Kashmir जाता है जो. Daniel, who was returning to Lhasa. Anybody, I didn't ask you, anybody of you had experience of such, you can say, going into that journeys which are quite tough, moving into your cars, maybe with your family or friends, going into the snow, wearing those gum boots and getting only Maggie or noodles to eat with cup of coffee over there, no other good meal. Any of you? You can just tell that, you can share your experience if you had, or just you can tell whether you had it or not. Nobody? So nobody is raising hand. It means no one had such experience. It's not possible. It's not possible. Okay, who's listening to me? Raise your hands. Let me check for the attendance sake. Now all are saying yes. So you are listening, but who had the experience? Now that child, raise your hand. No need to send thumbs up now. All of you are listening. Anybody of you had such experience of going into that icy cold weather where there is no one around, or you can say you are driving in a tough circumstances and not a single child. Reason might be you are hesitant of speaking because I know many of you go to celebrate your, you know, vacation days and enjoy that rallies during the summer vacation and winter vacation. You are out always, but you don't want to speak, I guess. That's why you are not raising your hand. So such experiences are memorable always, and one should share because they are relatable things. Though we have not traveled to Mount Kailash, but yes, we can relate, even though if you have gone to any hill station. So they suffered, you know, Daniel, who was returning to Lhasa, found a ride in a truck to So Satan, and I bade him farewell outside a tire repair shop. So please note down here, when they reached the small town of Hoor, Daniel, who was returning to Lhasa, found a ride in a truck. So Satan and I bade him farewell. Daniel Cornett, translator, who was helping the narrator to speak the local language or understand the local language. So Daniel has gone at this place, or he got a ride in a truck. So ab kaun reh gaya narrator ke saath? Nick Middleton ke saath, Satan. And they, because they had two punctures in the quick succession on the drive down from the Salt Lake, and Satan was eager to have them fixed because Satan ki car thi wo kharab ho rahi thi, so he was so eager to get it fixed since they left him with no spares. The second tire he had changed had been replaced by one that was as smooth as my bald head. So they are saying that even the smoothest of the things were not working in the rough weather. You know, and the people who go to such journeys, they know the art of changing tires and how to survive in this tough circumstance, and they have been changing it also. But even then, they suffered with the two, you can say, punctures. Hor, now please underline, describe Hor. It's a question in itself. Hor was a grim. Grim means very serious, miserable place. There was no vegetation whatsoever, just dust and rocks. वहाँ पे बहुत dust and rocky area it is, liberally scattered with years of accumulated refuse, जहाँ पे कोई आता जाता ही नहीं है. Which was unfortunate given that the town sat on the shore of Lake Mansarovar. This is reality. This is on the shore of Lake Mansarovar and it is very less vegetative place and very miserable. You know, when you see no people around, how are you going to enjoy all alone? When there is no vegetation, no people, no movement, you're going to feel so sick over there. Tibet's most venerated stretch of water. Ancient Hindu and Buddhist cosmology pinpoints. Mansarovar mein log bahut jaate hain. Buddhist people, ancient Hindu people, they definitely go to Mansarovar as the source of four great Indian rivers. Those who think that, you know, taking dip into the holy rivers will save their life and the fortune will be saved. Indus, Ganges, Satluj and Brahmaputra. So these are the source of four great Indian rivers. So that's why this Mansarovar has some special impact on Hindu mythology and Buddhist mythology as well. Actually, only the Satluj flows from the lake, but the headwaters of the others all rise nearby on the flanks of Mount Kailash. We were within striking distance of the great mountain and why I was eager to forge ahead. So their destination is coming nearer and they're getting excited, but they have to wait, obviously. I had to wait. The narrator was excited that they are reaching near to the destination. Satan told me to go and drink some tea in Hor's only cafe, which, like all other buildings in town, was constructed from badly painted concrete and had three broken windows. So only cafe, pure Hor way. It is so miserable place that there is only one cafe, like all other buildings in town, badly constructed, three broken windows. लेक का व्यू बहुत अच्छा आ रहा है एंड दे हैव टू यू नो लुक एट द लेक ओनली फ्रॉम द ब्रोकन विंडोज और दैट लाइक दिस थिंग. आई वाज सर्वड बाय अ चाइनीज यूथ इन मिलिट्री यूनिफॉर्म हु स्प्रेड द ग्रीस अराउंड ऑन माय टेबल विद अ फिल्दी रैग बिफोर ब्रिंगिंग मी अ ग्लास एंड अ थर्मस ऑफ टी. सो वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग इट टुमारो बेटा. Bell has gone. So hopefully we will continue maybe tomorrow or the next day. Let's whatever will be the schedule, I will inform you. So make sure that you eat your meal well, you come up in the school uniform, and you should bring your mobile and copy of Aadhaar card with you, and definitely bring your mobile also as per the instructions already circulated. All the best for tomorrow. Have a nice day.